I have a question. The second you saw, you got the text that Jrue Holiday is coming to Boston, were you in the back of your mind? You know, a lot of things have to happen. You know how tough it is to get through. In the back of your mind, are you like, we're winning this shit?
At first, I was like, I can't believe Milwaukee let this happen. So thanks to the Bucks. But yeah, kind of. I knew we had a really good chance. To win a championship, a lot of things have to go right. You have to stay healthy, have to be on the same page. People have to get along. It's a little bit of luck that's involved. But knowing that Jrue had championship DNA and I won a gold medal with him, I knew, you know, what kind of player and person that he was. I knew it was going to make our team better. And we already got KP, and we already had a really good team. So, yeah, when we got Jrue, I was pretty confident about what we could accomplish.
Is there someone for you, you guys, where you feel like, oh, when we got
Candace?
Oh, okay. I thought you were going to say Chelsea. Chelsea. Too, I mean, I'm joking.
But even then, like,
honestly, you have, like, you could pick from all of them.
But when we got Candace, I was like, our roster's looking pretty nice. Like, okay. It was just one of those things that I was like, it can look great on paper. And I've been on teams where it looks so good on paper. And then when it's on court, it's like a shit show. So when we got Candace and I finally got to, like, play alongside her, I was like, okay, this could be something.
Well, to that point, we talk a lot about Alicia and her impact. We were talking about it during the finals last year, but Sue's former teammate and just what she brings. You have a lot of teammates like this. You know, Derek is one, but there's a bunch going up and down the list. What do you guys think makes, just broadly, what makes a good role player? Like, what makes somebody who is like, when this person is on your team, whether it's your team or an opponent, you know they are going to provide something that is just an intangible.
The little things, like you said, the intangibles, just the 50-50 balls, like just anything, things that don't show up on the stat sheet, I feel like it's so key when it comes to role players, and you honestly can't win without them. They're some of the biggest ones that make the biggest plays at the right moment because, I mean, superstars are going to be superstars. At the end of the day, you're going to get what you're going to get out of them, but it's like who's doing the little things that superstars can't always do, and that's the separation factor right there.
Yeah, and it's like, role players on a championship team would be, one or two on a different team. Like the fact that Jrue Holiday and D. White are considered our role players, we're extremely lucky.
It's not cool.
And like she said, like the superstars, like you're going to have off nights, especially in the playoffs. It's just how it goes. And in those moments when role players or guys off the bench can buy you a 3-minute stretch or whatever it is that where they make plays and hit shots and then you come back into the game and now everybody's rolling. It really is a collective effort. You never know when a role player can win you a playoff game, and that's so valuable.
Yeah, it's like a stress reliever when you're sitting on the bench and you see them, even if they just keep the score where it was when you came out.
Yes.
It gives you a little bit more. Mm-hmm. What I find interesting about role players is in a lot of ways we talk about the superstars and their egos. Mm-hmm. Do they have one? Do they not? How do they embrace their teammates? To me, the role player's ego is so interesting because, like you said, they could be number one, number two on another team. And yet they choose to be, God, I was going to say lesser. That does not do it justice. It's not lesser. I got to get a new vocabulary here. But they're choosing a lesser role, right? They have to be efficient in that role. Yeah. And yet their ego never comes in. Yeah. And I always find that fascinating because we always talk about egos of superstars, but never about the role players. And they're the ones that have to probably take even a bigger hit in a lot of ways and continue to show up, continue to be efficient. That's how I feel about AC, about Alicia Clark.
Yes.
Like she just comes in, she's going to guard the best player. Yes. She's going to hit the corner three. She's going to yap at the ref a little bit when they call a foul
she's
on her. But players like that are so important.